Hello students, let us continue our module 3. In the previous class we have stopped to this particular three-dimensional notation. In that we have discussed that is the three-dimensional notation about rotation about z-axis. Okay, so in that I have said about that is x dash equals to x cos theta minus y into sin theta, y dash equals to x cos sin theta plus y into cos theta, and z dash equals to z. Okay, so this is nothing but, as I've said, that z value will be remain constant. Okay, and x and y values will be get changing. Okay, so in the matrix form we have represented in this way. Okay, as well as I already said that the first row is completely x, second is y, third is z, and the last one is homogeneous, that is 1. Okay, so similarly the first column is x, second is y, third is z, and fourth one is, that is homogeneous. Okay, that is value is 1. Okay, so once you get this matrix, okay, for rotation about z axis, can we go for the rotation about x axis and y axis? Yes, we can go for rotation about x axis and y axis also. But here, rather than using, okay, this way of using the equations, okay, by plotting the x-axis, y-axis, okay, and calculating the sine theta, cos theta, applying the addition of angles and all, okay, we can just use a very shortcut method called cyclic permutation. Okay, so that is nothing but, see here, the cyclic permutation, which says that first x will start, after that y will come, after that z, after that x. Okay, so after x again y will start, so a kind of continuation will be there. Okay, so first always x, after that y, after that z, after that again x will start. Okay, so in the same sense, okay, if you want to do rotation about x-axis, okay, just you have to change. Okay, so what was the x? Okay, x will be kept last. Okay, otherwise you can keep it at the top also, x dash equals to x, because x value will not get changed. What is the next one? That is a y and z, right? So we want to perform rotation about x axis in which x dash is equals to x only. Okay, so the next one is y and z. Here what is the first element? That is a y, right? So in this equation, the first row, okay, in which the y values will be written. Okay, so similarly, what is the second element? That is a z, right? So the z element will be written in the second column. So it will become y cos theta minus z sine theta. Z dash equals to y sine theta plus z cos theta. Okay, I hope you understood. Just we are changing, okay, the y and z values, okay. And x value will be as it is, that is x dash equals to x, because it is rotation about x axis. You can see in this figure, this is the x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis. Okay, so in this x axis, okay, the counterclockwise rotation will be done, that is a positive rotation, and this y and z, okay, that values will be get changed. Okay, so this is a rotation about x axis. What about rotation about y axis? Same thing. Okay, so we will keep y dash equals to y. Okay, so after the y, what is there? That is a z, right? After the z, what is there? That is x, right? So we are following the cyclic permutation. So see here, we should not start with the x, right? Because we are going to come out of the order, because here we are performing rotation about x, y axis. So after the y, what will be the next element? That is z, right? After the z, x will come, right? In the same sense, here we are going to use the same equation, that is z dash, okay, which is the first element. So the first column will be z element. Second element is x, okay? So the second row is a, that is x element. So it will become z dash equals to z cos theta minus x sine theta, x dash equals to z sine theta plus x cos theta. Okay, y dash will be y only. You can see that here, this is a y, so it is a rotation about y axis. Okay, so this is a x z plane. Okay, so here only the x and z values will be get differ. Okay, y value will be remain as it is. Okay, as you can, as you have seen that, once you remember rotation about z-axis, okay, you can easily plot. You can easily plot the matrix for the rotation about x-axis as well as the rotation of y-axis. Okay, just you have to follow this cyclic permutation. Okay. Now, what about inverse rotation? Okay, as we have already discussed that that is a minus rotation means inverse rotation means minus theta we are going to use, right? And for the minus theta means it is a we are going to perform the clockwise rotation, right? So in that we are going to use cos of minus theta. Okay, so in this equation, assume that here I'm performing the inverse rotation. Okay, so this is a rotation. Inverse rotation, that is a minus theta rotation about z axis, okay, with the minus theta. So here we are going to apply cos of minus theta. Cos of minus theta is, that is cos theta. Minus of minus sine of minus theta, that will become plus sine theta, right? So in the same sense here, sine of minus theta, it will become minus sine theta. Cos of minus theta, it will become cos theta. Okay, that you already studied in your PUC, in the trigonometry concepts, right? I hope you understood this particular concept. Okay, there is a one possibility, that is nothing but either you can apply this cos of minus theta and sine of minus theta. Otherwise, you can do one thing, that is just to transpose this matrix. Okay, apply the transpose matrix. Okay, as we know that what is a transpose of a matrix. Okay, that is nothing but each rows will be converted into columns and every columns will be converted into rows. Okay, that is a one more method. Okay, that is what written here. Okay, so r of minus one. Okay, r of minus means it is an inverse rotation, that is equals to transpose of the rotation matrix, right? I hope you understood. Okay, fine. So now we are going to see the next concept, that is a general three-dimensional rotations. Okay, so in the textbook they have already given this three-dimensional rotations, but they are not that much students friendly. Okay, so that is why I have taken the concept from the second textbook. Okay, that is the Interactive Computer Graphics by Edward Angel. Okay, so in that textbook he has clearly and nicely has explained, so that is why I have taken the concept from that textbook. Okay, so in this general three-dimensional rotation, we are having three important concepts. That is rotation about a fixed point, rotation about an arbitrary axis, and finally quaternion methods for three-dimensional rotations. Okay, so from the exam perspective, these are very important questions. Okay, in the exam they may ask rotation about a fixed point, or they may ask rotation about an arbitrary axis. Okay, so the carrying of these marks will be more. Okay, means it may ask for 7 to 10 marks. Okay, so you should focus on this one. And our lab program is based on this rotation about a fixed point. Okay, so we have to give more importance to this three conditions. Okay, especially in that this first two conditions. Okay, so in that I have used I have written the notes. My handwritten notes is there, which is already uploaded in the Moodle. Okay, you can download it from there. Okay, so it will clarify all your doubts. Okay, so three-dimensional rotations, in that general three-dimensional rotations. So first one is rotation about a fixed point. Okay, what is this rotation about fixed point? As I already said that whenever you want to perform the rotation, we have to keep three important things in our mind. That is, first one is fixed point. Okay, so with the help of that fixed point, we can rotate the given object. Okay, the second one is, that is a rotational angle. Okay, rotational angle theta. Okay, if you want to perform the positive rotation, which indicates that you are performing the counterclockwise direction, counterclockwise rotation. Okay, if you want to perform the negative rotation, means you are performing the clockwise rotation. Okay. And the last condition is, that is, we are going to use a line segment. Okay, line segment or the line vector. Okay, through which we can rotate our given object. Okay, so see here, this is the given object. Okay, which is placed in some coordinate frame, that is x, y, and z. Now this is the cube, that is my polygon. In that, I can choose any point as a fixed point. So let me take the centroid of this cube as a fixed point, and I'm going to name it as a PF. PF means fixed point. Okay. The next one is I want to apply the rotation, right? Okay. That should be the counterclockwise rotation, positive rotation. So I'm going to apply the theta. Okay. So once I do this one, okay, so I'm going to get a rotated object like here. Okay, see here, the dotted line indicates that dotted cube is nothing but the original orientation of the cube. Okay, and this solid line based cubes are nothing but that is after the rotation. Okay, what is the orientation of our cube? Okay, what is the problem in this particular thing? Okay, so here I want to perform the rotation about z axis. Okay, so in that I have satisfied two conditions for the rotation. That is, I got the fixed point, I got the rotation angle, but one thing is missing. What is that? That is nothing but rotation about, that is nothing but I want rotate about some axis, right? For that, I should use the line vector. Okay, I should need one support. Okay, I need one support. As I have given one example, I hope in the some restaurant, okay, I hope you have seen that tikkas and all, okay, they will use some kind of wire, okay, that kind of a thin rod will be there, okay. So if assume that that paneer will be taken, okay, so they will insert that particular wire into that paneer, right? So that is that wherever they are inserting, right, that is taken as a fixed point, okay, that whatever they are inserting, right, that is a thing line segment, okay, after the insertion, what they are going to do, they are going to rotate that wire, right? I hope you are getting my point. Okay, so that they can bake that paneer. I hope you understood. I hope you got such kind of imagination. Okay, so in the same sense, okay, so in this condition, my angle is there, my fixed point is there, but I don't have the vector. Okay, I don't have the line segment or the line vector. For that, what I'm going to do here, okay, this particular cube, okay, I have taken the fixed point, okay, and rotation angle also I know. So anyhow, I have the three wires, okay, let us, you can consider that this three wires, okay, it may be the X wire or Y wire or Z wire, okay. So these are the kind of line segment, okay. So with the help of this line segment, I can able to rotate, okay. So first, what I'm going to do, with the help of this fixed point, I'm going to perform the inverse translation. Okay, means inverse translation means what? I am going to bring this particular cube towards the origin of this particular coordinate frame. Yes, the inverse translation has been done, right? Now I got three support vectors. That's the thing, but X is there, Y is there, and Z is there, which is the thing but your wire, right? Now, with respect to that, here I am performing rotation about Z axis, right? So here, Z will be taken as a very important wire, okay? So next, I'm going to perform the rotation with the specified angle theta, okay? Once the desired rotation has been performed, what is my next job? Okay, I'm going to perform the translation, okay? I'm going to keep that object to the same location where previously it was, okay? I hope you understood what is this rotation about, rotation of a fixed point, okay? First, you have to perform the inverse translation, okay? Then you have to rotate with that desired angle, okay? Then again, you perform the positive translation, okay? So that is what it is written here. In terms of the basic affine transformation, we will discuss what is an affine transformation in the upcoming classes. The first is we have to perform T of minus PF. Minus PF means that is a inverse translation. Minus PF means minus XF, minus YF, minus ZF. Okay. So PF means it is a fixed point. So XF means fixed X value. Okay. YF means fixed Y value. ZF means fixed Z value. Okay. Once this inverse transition is performed, okay, then you can go for rotation about Z axis. See, these are the kind of synonym, the subscripts you should use. Okay. So it will say that it is a rotation about Z axis with that specified angle theta. Okay. And finally, once the rotation has been done, then you can go for the translation, positive translation. Okay. So how we can represent this one in a matrix form? Yes. What is the first one? what is the first operation that I have performed? That was a T of minus PF. After that, rotation about Z axis. After that, positive translation, right? As I've said that in the computer graphics, we always perform the operations from the right side to towards the left side. Okay, so means this particular inverse translation has been performed initially, later the rotation about Z axis, and later this positive translation has been performed. Okay, so now here T of minus PF. Okay, can I represent this one in a matrix form? Yes, that is a T of minus XF and YF, right? So here we have taken that ZF value is equals to 1. Okay, or we have taken that ZF value is equals to 0. Okay, we are not going to consider that. Okay, because anyhow, Z value is never going to change, right? We are taken as it is because we are not applying the translation to the Z axis. We are applying the translation only to the X axis and Y axis. Okay, so here I can represent that. Yes, this is the X row, this is the Y row, this is the Z row, and this is the homogeneous, that is 1. Okay, so X to the X, that is a 1. Okay, so 0, 0, and minus XF. Okay, once you, as we already seen that, okay, in the 4 cross 4 matrix for the translation, okay, you can refer that once again. The next one, 0, 1, 0, minus YF. 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so this is our inverse translation matrix. What is the rotation about Z axis? Okay, that is a cos theta minus sin theta, 0, 0, sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, right? And positive translation, that is nothing but 1, 0, 0, right? Just in place of negative, you are putting the positive, that's all. Okay, so when I got, once I got all this 3-4 cross 4 matrix, okay, I'm going to perform the matrix multiplication. Okay, I hope you know how to perform the matrix multiplication. Okay, once the matrix multiplication has been done, okay, we will get this resultant matrix. Okay, so that is a cos theta minus sin theta 0 minus xf cos theta, okay, minus 1 plus YF sin theta, sin theta cos theta 0 minus YF cos theta minus 1 minus XF cos theta 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, so this is the same resultant matrix that we are going to use in our lab program. That is the second lab program, rotation of a triangle. Okay, so whatever the concept that we have studied in this session, okay, is applied in the second lab program. That is rotation of a triangle. Okay, I hope you, if you open up your course laboratory manual, you can get a kind of equation, that is a m of 15 is equals to 0, means initially all the matrices are initialized to 0. Okay, and after that m of 0 is cos theta, m of 1 is sin theta. Okay, that we have mentioned in that way. So here in the open GL, whenever we are represented in a matrix form, okay, but normally we are going to use a variables and we will store the values, right? We are going to use the arrays, okay, arrays, and in that we are going to store this 16 elements, right? So here we have a 16 elements, 4 cross 4 means totally 16 elements are there. So here in the OpenGL, it always follows the column major order, okay? Column major order means that, so If I want to represent every these coefficients in an array form, so this will become m of 0, okay, first element. Second one, m of 1, m of 2, m of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, okay. So in that way, we are going to store the values. So remember that in the OpenGL, we are going to use the column major order rather than row major order. Okay, so don't get confused that m of 0, m of 1, m of 2. No, that is not a row major order, it will follow the column major order. Okay, so if you understood, you without any problem, you can easily execute the second lab program. Okay, if you have any kind of doubt regarding to this one, you can ask me. Okay, now the next one is again one more very important concept, that is a rotation about an arbitrary axis. Okay, what is this rotation about an arbitrary axis? So here in the rotation about a fixed point, it is having some kind of drawback. So that is nothing but that. What is the drawback is, we will assume that whatever the rotation that we are going to perform, which is nothing but it is very accurate one. Okay. But actually we don't know that that a particular cube is already having some angle with respect to x-axis and y-axis, right? So we don't want that angles. Okay. We want a fresh angle. Okay. So that we can only apply those angle that we are desired of. Okay. So to eliminate that drawback, okay, we are going to use this rotation about an arbitrary axis. Okay. What we are going to do here? Here, consider a rotation of cube as shown in the figure. Okay. This is the cube. Okay. Fixed point is there. And next one is a rotation angle will be used. Okay. That is a theta. And along with that, we are going to use one arbitrary axis. Okay. One additional axis we are going to use. Okay. What is the use of this axis is, once we are here, this cube, okay, in this fixed point, we are going to insert this vector, okay, line segment vector, okay. Once we have inserted, then again we are going to perform the inverse translation, okay. Then we are going to perform the rotation, okay. And after that, again, we are going to perform the translation, okay. Let us see one by one. So here, we need three important entities to specify the rotation. What are those? First one is fixed point. Okay, that we assume that center of the cube. Second, vector about which we want to rotate. Okay, so here we are going to use this vector. Okay, and the last one is angle of rotation. Positive rotation means that is counterclockwise rotation. Okay, so now the vector about which we wish to rotate the cube can be specified by the using two points. Okay, so we are going to name, okay, P1 and P2 on this particular line segment. Okay, so here I am traversing from P1 to towards P2. Okay, the direction will be taken. Okay, vector means, as we know, that it having some set of magnitude and the direction. Okay, so here let me take the distance, that is u. Okay, u equals to P2 minus P1. P2 minus P1 means it indicates that here this direction indicates that it is a positive rotation. Okay, P2 minus P1 means it is moving from left side to the right side. Okay, so it is a positive rotation. If I'm taking from the right side to left side, which indicates that I'm performing the negative rotation. Okay, so here, one note here, that is the order of the point determines the positive direction of the rotation of for theta. And that, even though we draw is passing through the P0, only the orientation of the U matters. Okay, which indicates that whatever that I've said, okay, whenever you're moving from left to right, which indicates it is a positive rotation. If you're moving from right to left, it will become negative rotation. Okay, so now we are going to use V. Okay, V is a unit length vector. Okay, so that is U by modulus of U. Okay, so that is nothing but alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z. What is this alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z? These are the small changes in the with respect to x axis, with respect to y axis, and z axis. Okay, so that is nothing but, we will see in the upcoming, okay, what is that alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z? Or in the short, whenever you square them, that is alpha x square plus alpha y square plus alpha z square, you are going to get the value as 1. Okay, that is what we call as a unit length vector. Okay, whenever you square this alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z, and whenever you sum up this square, you are going to get the 1. Okay, and 1 is the maximum value. Okay, and 0 is the very minimum value. Okay, we have already seen that moving the fixed point, okay, to the origin. Thus, the first transformation is a translation, right? That is, we have performed the inverse translation. And the final is the positive translation. After the initial translation, the required rotation pattern problem is shown in the figure. Okay, so what he's saying here is, okay, so there, we can't come to know that whatever the rotation that we are going to perform, it will going to give us a desired rotation. Okay, anyhow, with the help of this XYZ axis, we are going to perform the rotation. But am I going to get a desired rotation? That is the problem. Okay, so that is why instead of using this rotation of about a fixed point, we are going to use the rotation about an arbitrary axis. Okay, this arbitrary axis plays a very important role. Okay, so our strategy is to carry out two rotation to align the axis of rotation V with the Z axis. Okay, our main intention is we want to rotate about Z axis. Okay, then we can rotate about by the theta about Z axis, right? After which we can undo the two rotation that did the align. What is the meaning of this sentence? Here, my desired rotation is rotation about Z axis, right? So before doing the rotation of Z axis, let me do the rotation of X axis, then rotation about Y axis, then rotation about Z axis. Once the desired rotation has been done, I'm going to undo the previous rotational operation. Okay, so that is RY, that is rotation of Y axis, and I'm going to undo the rotation of X axis so that I'm going to get a very accurate rotation about Z axis. Okay, I hope you understood my point. Okay, so see here, that is, if this is the cube which is placed in the center of this origin of this XYZ coordinate. Okay, first I'm going to perform the rotation about X axis. Okay, that is a positive rotation, then rotation about Y axis. Okay, then the Z axis. After that, I'm going to undo the operation. Okay, see here, what is the order? First is X, after that Y, after that Z. Okay, after that, again, I'm going to undo the Y. See, I'm not using the X because previously only I've done the Y. Okay, so let me undo the Y operation. Then I can go for undoing the X operation. Okay, so in this order, we have to maintain these operations. Okay, so here the difficult part, the processing is to determine the, we determining the, that is, we proceed by looking at the components of V, because V is a unit length vector. As I've said, that alpha x square plus alpha y square plus alpha z square is equals to 1. Okay. So here, this alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z, okay, that will be drawn perpendicular to our x, y, and z axes. Okay, so see here. So if this is the our unit length vector V, okay, so this particular dotted lines is nothing but our alpha y, okay, and this particular distance is nothing but alpha x, okay, and this particular distance is alpha z, okay. So with that, they are having some angles also. These angles we call it as a direction angles. Okay, that we are going to name it as a phi x, phi y, and phi z. These are the angles between the line segment and the axis. These are the angles between the given axis and the line segment. Okay, we call them as a direction cosines. Okay, because that will determine the in which direction. Okay, we are rotating, whether we are performing the positive rotation or whether we are performing the negative rotation. Okay, so here, if you see here, a kind of triangles, okay, that it is made here. Okay, so that is nothing but a cos of phi x. Cos of phi x is nothing but alpha x. Where is the alpha x? Okay, this is the alpha x. Okay, cos of phi x is nothing but alpha x. Okay. And next one, I hope you can solve that one. Okay, cos phi x is nothing but alpha x. What is the alpha x? Okay, this is the alpha x. Okay, so as we know that V is 1. Okay, so unit length vector is 1. That is nothing but cos of phi x equals to alpha x by 1. Okay, so 1 is, we are not going to represent here. So we are directly representing it as a alpha x. Similarly, cos y equals to alpha y by 1. Okay, 1 is nothing but that is a V value. And next one, cos phi z equals to alpha z by 1. Okay, so next one, as I go through this equation, what is that equation? Alpha x square plus alpha y square plus alpha z square equals to 1. Okay, so if I'm apply this one in this equation, I'm going to get cos square phi x plus cos square phi y plus cos square phi z equals to 1. Okay, So next, now I can perform the rotation with respect to x-axis and y-axis. Why we are performing rotation of x-axis and y-axis? Okay, because before doing the rotation about z-axis, let me do the rotation about x-axis and y-axis. Okay, so that I can feel that I'm performing the very accurate rotation about z-axis. Okay, so here, yes, this is the our unit length vector. Okay, that is having the alpha x, alpha y, and alpha z. Okay, so once you rotate that one, okay, about x-axis, so this particular unit length vector will come under this xz plane, right? It will come to this xz plane, okay? And this vector, okay, its shadow will be fall on this yz plane, okay? In this yz plane. So here we are going to represent this one as a, this is the alpha z and this is the alpha y. What is a d? D is nothing but a kind of a shadow, okay? A shadow line segment, okay? So here it is written that it shows that the effect of the desired rotation on the point alpha x, alpha y, alpha z is to rotate the line segment into the plane y equals to 0. Okay, that is plane y equals to 0. Okay, if we look at the projection of the line segment on the plane x equals to 0, plane x equals to 0 means this is completely x equals to 0. Okay, means only we are dealing with this plane. Okay, that is a yz plane. We are going to get a kind of shadow line segment, that is a d. Okay, with what is the value of d? That d is nothing but alpha y square plus alpha z square, okay, whole square of that one, okay, whole square root of that one, okay, that is called as a foreshortened. Okay, so once you compute, okay, the what is the values of this one in a matrix form, okay, you are going to get in such kind of equation. That is the r rotation about x-axis equals to x with the x, that is 1, okay, because you are not going to change the x value. X with the y, that is 0. X with the z is 0. X with the h, that is also 0. The next one, y with the x, no, because we are not going to change the x value. Y with the y, yes, there is a alpha z by d, okay, alpha z by d. Okay, just to follow this alpha z by d. Okay, now the d value is not equals to 1, right? What is the d value? It is a foreshortened. Okay, means which value is less than 1 now. Okay, minus means now y with the z, that is alpha minus alpha y divided by d. Okay, and next one is, that is z with the x, that is 0, z with the y, that is alpha y by d, and z with the z is alpha z by d, that is 0 and 0, 0, 0, 1. If you see carefully this one here, this is nothing but your cos theta. This is your minus sine theta. Okay, and this is your sine theta and this is your cos theta. Okay, but in our general rotation, okay, rotation about x-axis, we have used to that cos theta, sine theta like that. But here we have used alpha z, alpha y, okay, and d, okay. See, before understanding this one, you have to know the rotation about x-axis, okay. So we have already discussed rotation about x-axis and y-axis. Just you have to write that one in a matrix form, okay. Once you write that in a matrix form, once you compare with this matrix, you can easily identify what I've done here, okay. So once I'm done with the rotation about x-axis, then I can go for rotation about y-axis. Okay. So in the rotation about y-axis, so here we have this cos theta minus sine theta and cos theta. Okay. Where y with the y is 1 and x with the x, that is a d. D is not 1. Okay. It is the foreshortened. That is a root of alpha x square plus alpha z square. Okay. Okay. So finally, when we perform the concatenation of all these matrices, okay, what we will get? What I have done initially, first I have done the inverse translation, means the cube was there within the xyz coordinate frame. Within that, I have inserted the unit length vector v, okay, and with that unit length vector v, I have dragged that one to the origin of the coordinate frame xyz. After that, I am performing the rotation about x-axis, rotation about y-axis. After that, I'm going to perform the our desired rotation, rotation about z-axis. After this, I'm going to undo the rotation about y-axis and x-axis. Once all this rotation is done, I'm going to perform the positive translation, which is going to bring that, which is going to translate the object to its original location. Okay, I hope you understood this rotation about an arbitrary axis. From the beginning, it may look somewhat difficult. Okay, but once you see the content again and again, okay, you will get a concept. Okay, just you have to analyze that figures. Okay, that's all. Okay, there is no any rocket science in that. Okay, just you have to analyze the part. That's all. Okay, don't mug up. Okay, because if you are going to mug up, you're not going to understand. Ultimately, you are going to get confused. Okay, so let me do the last part of this one, last part of this session. That is a quaternions. Quaternions are nothing but they are the extension of your complex numbers. Okay, what are the complex numbers? Complex numbers are nothing but they are the kind of numbers. Okay, which are wider than the floating values and wider than the integer values, right? So which consists of a real part and the imaginary part. Okay, so as we have already seen that rotation is normally performed with the help of matrices, right? As we know that a matrix multiplication is very time consuming. Okay, so instead of using this matrices to perform the rotation, let us switch to the polar equations. Okay, polar equations are faster as compared to the matrix multiplication. Okay, so that is the beauty of this quaternion. So quaternions provide the advantage for the animation and the computer vision. Okay, normally wherever you can see this animation is processing, okay, and the computer vision is applied, okay, normally in that stages quaternions will be used. Okay, but the more usage can be seen in the astrophysics. Okay, so quaternions and rotation. Suppose that we use the vector part of a quaternion to represent the point in a space. That is the thing, but we are going to use p equals to 0 comma p. Okay, 0 is nothing but its initial location, and p is the distance. Okay, that is x, y and z. Okay, for the given location of the point. But in the quaternion, how we are going to represent? We are going to represent it as a r equals to cos theta by 2 comma sine theta by 2 into v. What is a v? V is nothing but unit length vector. Okay, we can then show that quaternion R is a unit quaternion. Okay, and therefore, whenever we are performing the inverse rotation, we are taking it as a R inverse. Okay, that is a quaternion rotation inverse. Okay, so cos of minus theta by 2, that is cos theta by 2, right? Sine of minus theta by 2 is minus sine theta by 2 into unit length vector v. Okay, so if we are considering the quaternion, product of quaternion p, and that represents the point with the r, we obtain the quaternion. That is, first one is a rotation, okay, inverse rotation, and after that the given point, again we are going to perform the rotation. Okay, so this is the way normally we are going to represent in a quaternion, but actually this is itself, it is having a very, it is a different concept. Okay, but in our syllabus they didn't mention much more about this one, so we will restrict to this one only. So here the quaternion, the end resultant value will be, that is a p dash. Okay, once we perform this multiplication, we will get cos square theta by 2 plus sine square theta by 2 and the particular point p, okay, with the dot product. Okay, see p dot v, it is a dot product we are going to use. It is not a multiplication, it is a dot product. Okay, and that will be multiplied with the v plus 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 v cross p. Okay, cross product will be applied over here, minus sine theta by 2 v cross p cross v. Okay, so don't go in deep about this one. Normally they will ask the question on this quaternion hardly for 4 to 5 marks. Okay, so how much is possible, that much you can memorize. Okay, the quaternion concept is already, it is also there in the notes. Okay, I suggest you to don't go through that one, go through this handwritten notes. Okay. So quaternions are faster, okay, in the hardware as well as in the software side. Okay. So here I'm going to stop the session. Okay. And remaining session we are going to do in the upcoming class. Okay. Thank you.